Okay, this flame coming out through the top of the can. Once that flame dies down, your char cloth is ready. You'll see it go down in a second. The principle behind this is that it's burned pretty much without oxygen. There we go. Flames out, that means your char cloth is done. So there it is, that's your finished char cloth right there. Beautiful. Let's try it. Try one piece. Doesn't take long to make. I'll try this big guy. Actually, we'll take it down a bit. Alright. So this is a piece of flint, and that's the steel. Yeah, that was dumb. You know, I light the whole can up. Hang on. Here we go. Oh, almost. There she goes. See? That's it. Well, that's the char cloth burning. Then you take that and you throw it into tinder. And it burns... You can blow it into flame. Good. It's done. Some of you might be asking what it is, what kind of can this in. This is a shoe polish can, believe it or not. And you just poke a little hole in the very top. That's it. You cut up your cloth, which has to be 100% cotton. Has to be. You cut the cloth up, be it by knife or scissors, whatever. Cut the cloth up into little squares, throw it inside the tin. Seal it, put it on top of your fire, and you saw the rest. Char cloth, there we go. And this is just a bent piece of bent steel. Limitations are huge. If it's damp out, wet out, good luck. Yeah, that's why I like to carry my my striker rod. It's much better, much more efficient. The hobo stove here, get something like this going around your camp all the time because it keeps the mosquitoes at bay. for this time of year, which is July, they can be pretty wild, right? Just keep a smoky fire going, you're good. It's not about speed out here. It's about being out here. It's not about... Yeah. It's just about being. Just about breathing. That's what it's about.